Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to discuss about introduction to algorithm. Algorithm, the word algorithm comes from the name of the Persian author who wrote a textbook in the field of mathematics. So later on, this word became more familiar in the field of computer science. We are using algorithm in order to create any program. So before making any program, so we need to create one algorithm. Based on the algorithm, we can write the program accordingly. So this algorithm is nothing but a method that can be used by the computer for solution of any given problem. For any given problem, if you want to find out any solution, so we can say that solution which is used by the computer is said to be a method, and this method we can call it as an algorithm. So formal definition of algorithm is a finite set of instruction that it followed accomplishes a particular task. A finite set of steps, or even we can say set of instruction that it will be followed to perform any particular task. This is nothing but algorithm. What is algorithm? A finite set of instruction or steps to be followed in order to accomplish any particular task is said to be algorithm. So why we are going to this algorithm? So if you don't use algorithm, so directly if you are going to the program, so if you are creating any program without algorithm, what happens there? If you do any mistakes in the program, then it is highly difficult to recover that error. For example, we will take one real life example. So here you are constructing one building, and without the plan, you are just going and you are constructing. You start your construction. So in the middle of the construction, if you want to do any changes, what happens? You have to demolish the entire building or whatever the thing you have constructed so far. So you have to demolish the full building, and afterwards again you need to reconstruct it. So it is a wastage of money and wastage of time, right? So we need to go for a plan initially, and if you want to do any changes in the plan, it is very easy to do changes in the plan itself before going for construction. And after confirming the plan, so we can go for construction in order to reduce the wastage of time and money. So in the same way, we are creating the algorithm initially, and after checking whether that algorithm works for all a set of inputs and whether it is producing the correct output, then we can go for creating the program. So if there is any changes in the algorithm, so we can do it algorithm itself, no need of changing the entire program after it has been written, right? So this is for this purpose we are actually going for algorithm concept. So now the next one we're going to discuss about what are all the characteristics of algorithm. Or we can also say these are all some of the criteria that the algorithm must satisfy. What are all the criteria? First one is input. Any algorithm may or may not have the input values. So we can have zero or more input for any algorithm. Next one is output. Any algorithm must have at least one output, one defined output will be there for any algorithm. Suppose if you don't have output, then what is the purpose of making that algorithm? No use of creating that algorithm, right? So you should your algorithm must contain at least one set of output. So at least one. So one or more output will be there for any algorithm. Third criteria is definiteness. Definiteness, which is nothing but each and every instruction whatever you return in our algorithm must be clear and unambiguous. So it should be clear, it should be understood by everyone. So you are developing one algorithm, and that algorithm will be used by many other person. So all the people who are all reading your algorithm must understand easily. So all your instruction must be very clear, and it should be unambiguous. What is the meaning of unambiguous? Again, you can take some other example for algorithm. So if you want to make a sandwich, So what is the first step to do any sandwich? So turn on your flame. You have to place the pan, and in that pan you have to place the add some bread slices and add butter. So like that your steps will be go on in order to prepare any sandwich. So suppose you are giving the algorithm for preparation of a sandwich. Turn on flame, place the pan. Next step will be add. Simply you are giving as add, which means what the thing you should add. We don't understand. So what to add in the pan? You want to add milk, or you want to add ghee, or you want to add water. So there is nothing defined in your algorithm. So you should not write like that algorithm. So your instruction given in the algorithm must be clear, and it must be very unambiguous, right? So you have to give the statement as add bread slice, add butter. So like that you have to specify each and everything whatever you want to do. So that is what the third criteria, that is definiteness. Next one is finiteness. So whatever the algorithm you are making, so it may consist of several steps. So all the number of steps should be finite. So what is the meaning of it? Once we completed all the number of instructions or the steps, the algorithm will be terminated. So we should know in advance when the algorithm will be terminated. That is what finiteness, which means if you include some looping structure in your algorithm. So what is the meaning of it? So if you have some for loop, say for example for int I equal to 0, I is less than n, I plus plus. Okay, so here we can able to understand how many times this particular loop will be executed. This is what. So because we know about till if it reaches the n value, so till that this particular loop will be executed. So we know how many times this particular loop will be executed. This is what finiteness. Your algorithm will be executed finite. Suppose you have one while loop in your algorithm, say for example while of 1. So what is the meaning of this while of 1? So every time you are executing this while of 1 statement, it returns the value as true. So all the time this loop will be executed, which means indefinite execution. So indefinite times this particular loop will be executed. So we may not know in advance how many times this particular loop will be executed. That cannot be a finite one. So these such instruction will not be included in your algorithm. So it will violate this criteria, that is finiteness. So whatever the instructions we have in your algorithm, so we can able to understand when your algorithm will be terminated. So all the instruction you are provided in your algorithm, all those instruction will be executed within a finite amount of time. So that is what finiteness. So next one is effectiveness. Effectiveness, which is nothing but your algorithm must contain the basic instructions. Like you even with the paper and pencil, you can able to find out what is the result you will get for execution of that algorithm. Right. So it must contain only the basic instructions, and your algorithm will be written in a basic language. So it is a easily understandable language. So whoever the people reading your algorithm, they must understand. Even they do not know the they don't have the knowledge of the computer or even any of the programming language, they must understand whatever the concept you have written in your algorithm. So that is what effectiveness. So it should produce the correct output for any set of input values. So that is what this criteria, that is effectiveness. So the effectiveness of algorithm must producing the correct output for any set of input values. Okay, so it should have the basic instruction. So these are all the five criterias that any algorithm must satisfy. So this is what the basic introduction about algorithm. And one more term which I would like to explain, which is nothing but computational programs. So if you are designing one algorithm, and that algorithm must satisfy these two criteria, that is definiteness and effectiveness, then we can say such algorithm or set to be computational procedures. All such algorithm are said to be computational procedure. So we can give one specific example for computational procedure, like running in programs in the operating system. So how the operating system will run all the programs? So it will take each and every program one by one. So after executing the second program, the third one will be executed. So it will not terminate at all. So it will be waiting for the new program that will enter into the ready queue. This is one of the example for computational procedure. Okay, thank you.